Hello guys, good evening, how are you all? Damn, so many people. Hello, hello all. Dhanush, Karthik, Naveen, Sindhu, Aditya, so many people. Nishita, Arun, Jaswant, Nishita. Yes, it's 6 p.m. to 8 p.m. How are you all buddies? Very good evening. CA Punarvas Jaikumar here. All right, so many of you are here. It's very nice to see you all. It's very nice to come back also. So first of all, buddies, I would want to apologize because the first revision was supposed to be on 11th, right? But I was diagnosed with COVID-19. So I also have survived corona. So it was around 15 days ago when, I mean not 15, sorry, it's been one month ago, where suddenly I was teaching about 12 to 15 hours and suddenly, you know, I felt sick. I had temperature of 103 degree Fahrenheit for almost 6-7 days. The thing is, my immunity fought against the virus, but still, because of which the fever never came down. So if the fever doesn't come down, it is a, you know, sign of the body fighting against the virus. So since the I was teaching a lot, the lungs exertion was a lot, and because of which the virus had affected the entire lungs. So I had to be hospitalized for almost around 8-9 days, after which the doctor told strictly till 12 September you cannot teach. He actually told till September end. So I said I'd rather die than, you know, wait till September end and all that. And in fact, friends, I just in fact, he told me that if you were 2 days late to the hospital, it would have resulted in complications and potentially you may have died also. So after having missed death, after having a near-death experience, you know, I have a different perspective of the coronavirus now. And also, I feel that it can happen to anyone. But do not worry, guys. Our body's immunity is very strong, actually. We can all fight the virus. So nothing, I'm a living example of having fought the virus and come out of it. So do not worry. So that's why there was a delay where I was supposed to take from 11th September, but it could not happen. So that's the reason why, buddies, I had to take today. Okay, so from today we'll be doing the classes. Today would be a small, what do you say, introduction and a small level of motivation for you, and then we'll start off with the basics of company law, and then going forward we will do other things. Okay, so buddies, the classes will be from sharp 6 p.m. to 8 p.m. Links have been sent to you for today and tomorrow, and later links will be, I mean, later, you know, it will be as a link on the my YouTube channel itself. So nothing to worry, we will do it. So today's links have been sent to you. I will be sending you the other link shortly. All right, so that's the thing. So very good evening, buddies. Material I will also be sharing on the group. Okay, I have a CA final group. Anyway, it's a law group. Law group, you can join that. I will tell you everything. Don't worry. I'll share you the materials. I'll share you the charts related to it. Okay. So we will go ahead with that. So on that note, guys, let us begin. Let us begin. Shall we? How's the Josh, everybody? So many of you are here, man. Crazy. How are you all? All fine? How's the Josh? How's it going for you at your end? Huh, guys, tell me. So I have the stream thing here. I'm seeing everything all fine. Brilliant. Chalo. So guys, as you can see here, a very warm welcome to all of you. We were during the CPT days, we were like this, and there was a huge jump from CPT to CA Inter. Huge jump, no? CPT to CA Inter. My doctor has told me 1.5 hours. If you go beyond 1.5 hours, 1 hour 45 minutes, I'll hit you. So I have to be very careful with my health now, next 10-15 days. So slowly, aram se will do it. He told me your lungs need relaxation, your lungs need to get back. So aram se will do, okay? No problem. And I'll also be handling a little bit of the audit portion also for you, okay? That's an extra bonus from my side. Because if you know, you have for new syllabus both, you know, company audit, which is both for law and auditing, both it will come. So in that sense of the term, we will do it. Okay, so we were in this CPT before, and suddenly we had to jump to CA Inter, right? CA Inter was like here, and from CA Inter you had to, you'll be jumping very soon to final. But guys, that CA Inter to final, nah, this jump actually is easy because you have already attuned your mind. But CPT to Inter or Foundation to Inter, this jump is slightly difficult. So all of you, most of you guys may be writing in November, some of you will be writing in May. Before we go to the law, subject, before we go to the law subject, we will be, I want to know, how is your mental state of mind now? I know, because first of all, those of you who will be writing in May now, unfortunately, will have to write in November. And of course, you'll be thinking whether November attempt will happen, will not happen, what am I doing, all these thoughts will be coming. So guys, before we actually go into the subject, all you need to attune your mind, you need to mold your mind. So I will be spending some time on that, because it is very, very important to stay motivated. It's okay if you revise even 8 subjects 100 times, but if you are not motivated enough, gone. So I have come here to slightly motivate you today. Right, I know there is a lot of stress going on, buddies. Even I have gone through the same. Right, even I am a chartered accountant. I have gone through CPT, CA Inter, final, and all that. Even I know the stress levels, how it will be. Right, whatever you are going through, I totally understand. So do not worry. But I need to slightly motivate you now to, go to the next level. Okay, so that is the reason. So come, tell me now. First of all, who is this guy? Anyone? Who is this guy? Sachin Tendulkar. Hey, what is this? Some of you, some privately are messaging me. Okay, on my phone also I am getting messages and all. Okay, who is this guy? Who is this guy? Yeah, I will share. Don't know. Naveen says, don't know, sir. Sir, it looks like James Bond, sir. I don't know. Vaibhav, I'll tell everything, buddy. Don't worry. Adolf Hitler. Manoj is telling Adolf Hitler. No. Guys, his name, Abraham Lincoln. No. This guy is named Karolai Takacs, right? So there's a small story about this guy, Karolai Takacs. What happened to Karolai Takacs, right? So, buddies, what was happening is, he was, as you can see, okay, if I had asked you 1 year ago, who is the best athlete in the world? You would have said Usain Bolt. You will not tell Ashish Nehra, Gautam Gambhir and all that. They unfortunately can't run so fast. You would tell Usain Bolt. This guy was like the Usain Bolt during 1900. Usain Bolt of pistol shooting. As you can see, he's a pistol shooter. So what happened, in 1900, 2 weeks before the Olympics, he was from the country Hungary, right? He was a Hungarian pistol shooter. He was also in the Hungarian army. So in the army, you do all your, army drills and all those things, right? In one such army drill, you had to handle a hand grenade. When he was handling a hand grenade 2 weeks before the Olympics, suddenly the grenade exploded and took away his right arm, his main shooting arm gone. Think about it. So 2 weeks before the Olympics, his shooting arm was gone. Then his right leg also he lost. So basically, he lost his right leg and his right arm, okay? So this was when? 2 weeks before the Olympics, okay? This was 2 weeks before the Olympics. Now, think about it. The entire world thought that he would win the Olympics, but just 2 weeks before the Olympics, his right arm gone, right leg gone. What do you do? If you and I were there, we would wallow ourselves in self-pity, maybe die, maybe go to enroll in a mental asylum because we'll lose our mind. This guy also disappeared for 6 to 8 months. That time there was no obviously, WhatsApp, phone, like, bro, where are you, bro? Can you please send your location, all that you can't do. It was 1900. So this guy, what did he do? They tried searching in crematoriums, they tried searching funeral homes, they tried searching him in mental asylums, but he was not there anywhere. 6 to 8 months later, and there was no prosthetic leg that time. It was just that wooden and iron heavy duty leg, and also right arm ke liye nothing was there. So buddies, after 6 months, he came to a local shooting championship, right? Local shooting championship he came, and as you can see, if you see, right leg is not there, it was that wooden stump, right arm was not there. He came, everyone was very happy to see him. They said, "Károly, come, come, become the chief coach of the Hungarian national team." You know what he said? "Boss, I have not come here to bloody sit and coach anybody. I am here to play." And he shot with his left arm. He shot with his left arm and won the championship. In 1905, if I'm not wrong, Olympics happened. Károly Takács won the gold medal. He beat everybody in the world using his left arm. Right? Then also, Vaishali lecture is in 100% English, right? There'll be no Hindi, English and all. It is 100% English, right? So kindly adjust, there is no Hindi, okay? So if you see, left arm, with his left arm he shot. He shot in that match and he won that particular thing. One more Olympics, he won. Then one or two Olympics, what happened? It was postponed because of the, World War. So this story I've been telling since 10 years, since 2008 when I started my teaching career, been 12 years now. So 2008 I cleared CPT, so I started teaching CPT students. That time only I had read about this guy's story and I felt it was amazing. I'm still surprised why no one has made this movie. Akshay Kumar should have made one movie, no? Still today, it is obviously not there. So this guy, what can we learn from this guy? See, I believe that we can learn something from everyone. Correct? So, Himanshu Bhai, aaj Hindi Divas hai, ek shabd nahi, do teen shabd bolunga, lekin aap please adjust kijiye, 100% English mein hum karenge, theek hai? Himanshu, are you happy? Yes. So, if you see guys, what can we learn from this? What can we learn from this? So, we can learn one thing from this, guys, that you see, we can learn something from everybody. When I came at 5:56, I already saw some 70-80 people on this thing. Now there are already some 200, I think 180 or something. So, see, you're already there, which shows that you have that zeal to learn. It is not about whether it's free classes, not free classes, I don't care. But you guys have the zeal to learn. You're taking out 2 hours from your time to do this. Correct? So, that's what I'm trying to tell. So, guys, what can we learn from this? Very, very simple. Do we concentrate on what we have lost, right arm? Or do we concentrate on what we have, right? Do we concentrate on what we have lost, right arm gone? Or do we concentrate on what we have? So buddies, if we can translate that to our lives, let us not concentrate on what we have lost. May 2020 attempt gone, correct? May 2020 attempt gone. Maybe you would have taken some attempt before also, that is also gone. It's okay. Do you concentrate on what you have lost? Oh, I should have been a CA by now. I should have been in final by now. Why did I take CA late? Okay. Guys, every 15 minutes I need to drink water because of my lungs. I hope you don't mind. Sorry. Because it is very essential for my health. I need to slowly getting back to normal. I'm still not fully normal. But only for you guys I'm here. Because I had made a promise to you that I am going to take classes, I will never say no to my promise. Okay, one second. Ah, thank you. Yes. So basically, guys, what I am trying to tell is, will you concentrate on what you have lost, right arm, and crib about the last time? Oh, I had done this, I had done that, I could have done this, my friends are already CA final, my juniors are all this year, all that will you think, or do you, it is better to concentrate on what we have. We have around 1.5-2 months to go for the exam and we can nail it. It is always better to concentrate on what we have. So I know what you are going through. You may be thinking about the past, correct? You may be thinking about a past, you may be thinking about what to do, what not to do. Why I could have done this better. Don't you think so? Am I telling the truth or not? You are thinking about all those things. See, law I will start, don't worry. But at least a little bit of time I want to motivate you because you need to come out of that thing now. I know you are going through a lot. So, before we start the class, I want you to be motivated because it's going to go for the next 7, 8 days, 10 days. Correct? But we have to move on. As one of you said here, Nishita has said that we have to move on. I know you are going through all this. I know you are thinking of all that. One more thing that, you know, oh, I have to take my parents' money, correct? All these things will be coming, correct? you will be feeling that I am already like 19, 20, 21, I am still living off my parents. Correct? My friends are already working, but I am still living off my parents. All these thoughts will come. Do not worry. It came to me also. I am also a human being. It happened to me also. Every single day I thought I am using my parents' money and all that. They didn't care. They obviously will not do anything. But every single day I thought, man, what is this? I am using my parents' money. I am not on my own 2 feet. All these thoughts will come. Banish those thoughts. It's okay. We are just in the learning period now. Once we clear, we'll earn a lot of money in CA. Don't worry. Okay? That is the thing. So let's be like Carolita Cox. Let us not concentrate on what we have lost, but let us concentrate on what we have. We have left arm. We can convert that left arm into a gold medal winning Olympic shooting arm. We can convert that left arm, that is the left time, to ensure that we clear CA Inter this time, right? Will we clear CA Inter? Yes, we will. Nobody is going to stop us. We are going to do it. I know. I mean, first of all, hats off to you guys. You guys are under tremendous pressure. May exam was there, November exam, and the stupid corona is ruining everything. So the thing is, it's fine. You are going through a lot. But the thing is, we should definitely enjoy this particular journey. Okay, guys? So let's be like Carolita Cox and let's move on. Next. How many of us have a mental barrier against any subject or subjects? I had a barrier against ITSM. Now you have EISSM. No, till today I swear I have no clue what that subject is. I don't know how I cleared. We had EISSM, ITSM, correct? So it will also go later. In CA final, his father will come, ISKA. Now for you, ISKA is removed, correct? So buddies, one thing. EIS, I hated that subject. For me, that was a mental barrier. So one of you says you have law against law, one of them EISSM, costing and all those things, okay? You fear taxation, costing, yeah. Each of you have a mental barrier. Each of you have a mental barrier, yes. Now we need to banish that barrier, okay? So I'll ask you a simple question. If I have to run a 2.1, 2.3 kilometers, how much time will you take? You may say, sir, I'll take 10 minutes, 15 minutes, 5 minutes. Sir, if you and I go, we'll go have coffee, we'll have breakfast, arams, I will walk and go, half an hour we'll go, sir. Like that you'll tell. But guys, law, some of you have costing, tax, audit, you have a mental barrier. Each of us have a mental barrier. For sure we have a mental barrier, no doubt about it. Many of you have for law, no problem, correct? Now, if I say, 2 kilometers if I have to run in 10 minutes, generally these athletes used to do it in 1950s and all, athletes used to do it in around 4 minutes. There was nobody who could do it in less than 4 minutes. So this was kind of stuck in everybody. The minimum time that you have to take for running 2 kilometers is, minimum time is 4 minutes. There was one, psychiatrist and an athlete. His name was Roger Bannister. Roger Bannister said, no, it is all in the mind. If the mind makes up the, if you make up your mind, anything is possible. You can definitely go and do it. That is what the, Roger Bannister told. So all the other athletes and other people told, Mr. Roger, if you feel that you can do it, why don't you do it? If you feel that all of us can do it, why don't you do it? Simply sitting here and talking, why don't you run and show? Like a challenge they threw at him. This guy said, yeah, good, let me do it. So if you see, there are no shoes also properly. This was in 1950. So he wore some whatever shoe that was available and he practiced for 6-7 months and he ran, guys. And when he ran, he took first time ever in the history of the world in 1950, 3 minutes 57 seconds. He broke that mental barrier. Everybody thought, no, this is it. In 2020, in our IPL and all that, 200, nobody thought of it. And now suddenly teams started hitting 200, 220, 230 and all those things. Correct? So in that way, it's a mental barrier. The beauty of this is, once Roger Bannister did it in less than 4 minutes, after that, you will not believe it. In the next 6 months, almost 8 people broke his record. Think about it, guys. For example, in cricket, nobody thought you know, you could score a century in, you know, a double century in a one-day international. After so many years, hundreds of years of cricket, Sachin Tendulkar broke that record, correct? Sachin Tendulkar broke that record. But if you think about it, Sachin Tendulkar broke that record and then what happened? See how many people have broken that record? Virendra Sehwag, I think, and our Rohit Sharma has done it thrice. So if you see, it is all a mental barrier. So let us break the mental barrier today. If you guys have any of the mental barriers, as you have mentioned here, so many people, please try to break the barrier, buddies. There is no point. Break the barrier. You can do it, right? So it's just a small barrier that you have in your mind that no, I can't do it, I can't do that, and all those things. So from today, all you need to do is you need to break that barrier and say, no, I am going to do it. Whatever comes, I am going to do it. Okay? So you will be able to do it, guys. This is about it. So let's all break our mental barrier like Roger Bannister. So first story, what I told was you need to now not think about what you have lost. Okay? So if I write down the important points that we have discussed, we should first point is we should ensure that we concentrate on what we have rather than what we have lost. Second one is you have to break your mental barriers, right? Now, how many of us feel CA is never ending? Your stupid relatives, some of our relatives are so stupid, they'll come and ask, I'll say, what are you doing CA? First question, which college? Aray, which college? What college? I am doing, you know, CA. Correct? Second question, which year? What which year? Every year we do it. There's no year. Correct? No. CA is the only course where seniors become juniors, junior become seniors. Correct? Which year? So the thing is, CA is never ending. It goes on and on and on and on and on. So if you see, that's the problem. So even my relatives used to ask, oh, which college? Okay, okay. Then I got some decent marks in IPCC. So they asked me how much percentage. I said some 60-65%. That's all. I felt like slapping that fellow. What you think it's bloody BCom to get 99%, 90% and all. That's all I is telling. So anyway, that's the thing. Anyway, so all these things happened. Relatives, no, suddenly they'll call you and like, my aunties, uncles, nephews, nieces, daughters, grandfather's son cleared. I said, so what can I do? No, no, I'm just telling you flunked. No, after result, day of the results, what happened to results? They'll ask, no, that's the thing. When I have not told them, it means I have flunked. So why simply call up and ask? So these relatives, no, stupid fellows there, leave it. So if you see, how many of us feel that CA are never ending? CA will never be ending. So if you see, that is how it is, guys. CA, in fact, will be never, never ending. It goes on and on and on. It is unbearable, right? So the thing is, one thing I'm going to ask you, buddies. What is this? This is called the Chinese bamboo. The Chinese bamboo grows for almost around 90 feet. And surprisingly, do you know how long it takes to grow? It takes 5 years and 3 months. Sir, what is the big deal about this, sir? 5 years and 3 months? Anyway, it will happen. What is the big deal about it? Why are you making a big deal about it? Guys, the best thing is for the first 5 years, it grows only one inch, this much. First 5 years, only 1 inch. So if you put it in your house, for the first 5 years, only 1 inch. Then it grows at the rate of 1 foot every day. For 90 days, it will be 90 feet. Crazy, no? So imagine you go to Goa for a week at the end of 5 years, and there a lot of spiritual activities happen in Goa, correct? Spiritual, like this and all, spiritual activities will happen. Then after 1 week, you will come. This bloody thing which was 1 inch has grown 7 feet. Now you will be wondering, is it hangover? What is happening? Correct? So that is the thing. So if you see, that is what? Spiritual activities, Vijay Mallya, Sri Vijay Mallya activities and all happen. Correct? So if you see, guys, this is the scene. 90 days, 90 feet tall. It is incredible. Crazy it is. So the thing is, what will it be doing for first 5 years? I say it will be doing articleship. correct? Because of the first 5 years, it will, you know, increase, I mean, it will just go across for almost around 50 feet, go below 50 feet, and it will just attach itself to Mother Earth. The foundation is being built. You also same thing. Foundation and inter is all your basic foundation. And then once you clear CA final, you will grow like the Chinese bamboo. So those of you who are feeling, that I'm using my parents' money, I don't know why, I'm feeling miserable, do not worry. Do not worry. Your parents do not mind doing all that for you. Please don't worry, buddies. All you need to worry about is you need to clear the exam. So lesson number one, Carolite Cox. And what is the lesson there? Concentrate on what you have. Second lesson was break your mental barriers. And third lesson is, I know CA is never ending, but this is a learning period, right? It is a learning period. So Vaibhav, as I told you, I am going to do a motivational session today. So if you are feeling that it is a waste of time and all, you may leave, because I am not going to start now. I need to build up the tempo, right? So I know your time is of the essence, but without motivation, I am not going to go ahead. So you need to be built up that motivation in such a way, later I am going to start. It's okay, I can take an extra day of class, I don't mind, but whatever I am doing, I have to do it properly. So I am not a person who will just do some 10 minutes of some motivation and then start the class. No, the motivation has to be built in such a way that it should, you know, encompass you. It will take you for the next 1.5-2 months. All right. So that is exactly why I am releasing these videos, so that I want my students to watch them, be with me, and then it will go ahead. These snippets will really take you a long way. All right. Yes. Next. Next point is, how many of us feel, correct, that we are not up for it? Because I took a survey 1 week ago. These are all the points students told me that I have to address. That is the reason why I am addressing. So it's actually not just for classes here, it is only to build your future also. Okay, so I honestly, if one or two people feel that what is this fellow doing, half an hour over, class has not begun, I am sorry, I cannot help it, right? Because this is your problems only. By the way, I took a survey and I got 7 questions. I am addressing those 7 questions in 2 minutes. Okay, so that is what I am trying to tell. Audit and EIS revision, I don't know what happened. You need to ask the faculty. Audit anyway, I am going to be doing a little bit of it, because the company audit portion is there. Company audit portion is there, so I will definitely be doing it in a while. So one second. So that is what I am trying to tell. So how many of us are not up for it is the question. How many of us are not up for the challenge? So we always feel, you know, because of this time, maybe you have taken a couple of attempts, you will always feel that maybe this is not up for it. I am not up for it. Maybe I am not cut out for doing CA. Maybe you will feel like that. So if you see, that is what I am trying to tell. Do not feel like that, guys. If I ask you a question, basketball, how long will you take to, obviously, how tall should you be for you to be a basketball player? So you should be 6 feet minimum. There was a guy 5 feet 2 inches, 5 feet, or sorry, 4 feet 10 inches. They said you can never be a basketball player, but he said, I don't care. Check it out. His name is Tyrone Bogues. See the height, buddies. He played for the Charlotte Hornets and he got the most valuable player award for 7 years in a row. He beat them all. He beat them all. All the people so tall, they were not able to move, but this guy used to move through their legs. Correct? So one of you is a basketball player. Great. So buddies, that's what I'm trying to tell. Basketball, people generally feel that you have to be 6 feet, but it's not like that. If you have the motivation, if you have the zeal, you can be a player. So this guy not only played, but he beat them all. All the players he beat for 7 years in a row. So if you feel today that you are not up for CA, do not worry. So these are the problems that students told me. Sir, I feel that I am not up for it. I feel CA is not for me. I feel very guilty that I am using my parents' money. I feel very sad that I lost 2-3 attempts. So I wanted to address this in the first class, a part of it, because it's very, very important for you to stay motivated. Trust me one thing, if I give you a question paper where you can sit at home and write aaram se, assuming that you are already a CA, you can easily write that question paper. But if I give you the same question paper in an examination environment where you have to write in 3 hours, you won't be able to do it because of pressure. So I personally believe you need to figure out and train the mind rather than the revision. So that training of the mind is what is happening now. So it is very, very important in my scientific analysis for a student to actually go through, I mean, whatever I am going through doing now, because you will be mentally strong. What should we do to reduce our sleep? Karthik says, you have to do pranayam, you have to do meditation. Meditation reduces your sleep. There are many shambhavi kriya, there is, you know, pranayama. So please do that. That will reduce your sleepiness and it will increase your alertness, and definitely you will sleep for a correct time, 5 to 6 hours, 7 hours, that's it. 8, 9, 10 hours and all really not needed. So you can utilize that time for studies, okay? So that is the thing, guys. I'm addressing your problems only. So I am there for you. I know what you're going through, and each of this, whatever I'm telling is true. I know that because even as a student, I also felt the same. And this, each of us is, you know, going through, we are feeling the pressure. As I told you, it is always about handling the pressure that really matters. We all feel the pressure now. We are unable to handle the pressure. See, one of you commented that half an hour over, please start the class, which is good. But why? That is the pressure that is talking. So you need to relax, you need to chill. It is after all an exam. Yesterday I was seeing that one lady was about to write the NEET examination, and she just committed suicide. And in the suicide note she told, I am very, very sorry that I could not match your expectations. I know I may fail in the examination, so I am committing suicide. I felt very, very sad. This is not the way to treat our students. We cannot pressurize them. So always think, guys, it is only an examination. Your life is more important, your mental health is more important. Once your mental health is there, anyway I know you will take care of your physical health, but if your mental health is there, only then you will be able to write your exam. Some of you are not understanding that point. If you study law 100 times also, nothing will happen if your mental health is not correct. Please get that in your mind, only then you will understand. One day before the exam, if you are seeing everything and then you go blank, then gone. Personally, it happened to me also. In CA final exam, first paper, financial reporting, I went blank. Half an hour, I don't know what I was thinking. So then I realized that mental health is so important. It does not matter how long you took to study, how many hours you studied, no, right? Balancing articleship, all that, yes, I know it is difficult, but we need to make time and do somehow. So real pressure. So there was a cricket match where Irfan Pathan was playing. He had already given around, you know, in 6 overs, he had given 57 runs. So there was no way in hell that last over 13 runs to get. So when you have given 66 overs, 57 runs, correct? So there are 6 overs and 57 runs when you have already given. So buddies, last over is there and you have 13 runs to get. Will you give the ball to Irfan Pathan to handle the last over? Definitely, if you were a captain, maybe you would not have given. But we had Mahendra Singh Dhoni, who was always a very different kind of captain. He went and gave the ball to Irfan Pathan. And this is what he did. First ball, one. Second ball, wicket. Third ball, two. Fourth ball, wicket. 2 wickets he took and he saved the match for India. So the thing is, in the post-match ceremony, Ravi Shastri was the commentator. He asked Irfan Pathan, how did you handle the pressure? How did you handle the pressure? So Irfan Pathan said one beautiful couple of sentences. He said, Ravi, this was not pressure at all. This I just had to bowl 6 balls and ensure that I don't give away 13 runs. What was real pressure was my dad in Baroda looked after me and my brother. He ensured that we walked every day 6 kilometers to play cricket. He ensured that we got 3 meals a day. He was just a very, very small cleaner in a mosque. In a mosque, he was a cleaner. He was getting some 4,000-5,000 rupees. And when my sister was getting married, they had to arrange for a 40,000 Activa bike. to be given to the groom as a gift. So when a person earns 3000 rupees per month, he had to buy the kits for us, cricket kits. He has to look after three children and he had to give three meals a day. And because of our diet, we had to eat chicken and all those things. He had to give three meals a day with 3000 rupees. That is pressure. This is not pressure. So guys, think about it. Do you have to give rent to your house? Do you have to buy a house? Do you have to bring vegetables to your house? No. The real pressure, whatever they are going through, is your parents. And they are handling the pressure really well. You don't have to worry. Just like Irfan Pathan had to bowl one over and not give away 13 runs, you have to write 8 exams and get 40 marks overall, 50. That's it. Even if you find that in a pressure cooker situation, it's okay. Do not worry. You have to get it in your mind. I keep on repeating. It doesn't matter if you study 100 times law, if your mental health is not in force. I want to test today, how is your mental health? I am seeing so many messages, sir, how to study for a long time, I am not able to study, I am only sleeping. So your mental health is very, very important. So you need to balance it. Trust me, we all don't even give a damn about our mental health, correct? So I know your mental state is bad. So this session, at least for the first few minutes now, I want you to understand that mental health is very, very important. Don't go behind law. I am there for law now. Do you trust me? Right? Do you trust me? I am there for law. I will do a quick revision of all the concepts. But mental health is something that you need to work on. I can only guide you. Right? So you are going through so many things. So I want to address those things first. Correct? That's the thing. So how to prepare on previous day? All these things they are asking. Yes, you will not get, one day before the exam you will not get. So don't worry, buddies. I am here. Let's discuss all those things. So let us stand tall and all those things. Finally, so plans, if you make, as Mukund says, it is of no use. You need to execute them. So today I'll make a plan. Oh, today I'll study 18 hours a day. At the end of the day, you'll study 80 minutes. So you need to assess your mental health. That is most important. If anybody asks me, how to clear CA examination? First thing is, how is your mental health? If your mental health is good, all loggy, all that is chiller, guys. You can aramse study. It is my subject. I respect my subject. When I say chiller, what I meant was not about the subject. Subject is solid. Subject is amazing. But you have the mental capability to handle any tough subject. So it's your willpower and your mental health that is very important. Please get that in your brain. That is why India, we are having so many suicides day by day, because our people do not know how to, all of us do not know how to, take care of our mental health. Correct? So that's the thing. Yes. Now, basically, we should always understand that true knowledge is power. Let us not go behind exemption. Let us not go behind, sir, which answer to write, what to study and all those things. Which time to study and all that, don't worry. I have already released a video, presentation aspects for the examination you need to go through. I will tell you what, after this session, I'll tell you. Okay. Now, coming to the session, will this last minute impetus, this last minute push of around 20 hours, whatever, 15, 20 hours, whatever we are doing, will this last minute push really help you? Yes or no? This last minute push, will it help or not? Because you've already studied everything. Now, why will it help you? Very simple, guys. If you see, who has won this match? The guy on the right hand side or the guy on the left hand side? Who has won this match is all that you need to see. So, is it the person on the right hand side or is it the person on the left hand side? If you observe very carefully, here you see his hand has already touched the surface and it has come down like this, correct? It has already touched the surface and it has reduced like that. So, this guy has already won the match. This is Michael Phelps of USA and this is Milorad Cevic of, I think it was Serbia or all that. Anyway, Michael Phelps, this guy had a fracture 2 weeks before the Olympics, correct? 2 weeks before the Olympics. Thank you, Sriram. Thank you so much. Thank you for reminding me. I have to keep having water. Thanks a lot. So thoughtful of you. Yes. So Michael Phelps was the guy who had a fracture 2 weeks before the Olympics, right? So they said, okay, chill, no problem, you go to the Olympics. This guy, what he did the first thing that everyone will do when they learn swimming. He held on to some support and he was beating his legs. He was beating his legs for 8 hours a day. He was beating his legs for 8 hours a day, right? So he's beating his legs for 8 hours a day. Crazy guy. So when the match came, this was the match where he got his sixth gold medal. This was the match when he got his sixth gold medal, believe it or not, sixth gold medal. So in this match, he won this match by 1/100th of a second. Can you believe it? 1/100th of a second. If you take 1 second and make it into 100 parts, one part, 1/100th of a second. Incredible guy. And if you see, when they analyze the results, they saw this guy became tired. You see, there is the water is very, very clear. But see this here, there's like a whirlpool, small whirlpool. This guy was beating till the last minute, last second, last millisecond. So this is like what we are doing now. You have already studied, you have already reached there. But have you still reached there? Did you win? No. So our revision batch will be like this last minute. The boiling point of water is 100 degrees centigrade. At 99 degrees centigrade, water is really hot. But at 100 degrees centigrade, it will convert to steam. And you can actually move a steam engine at 100 degrees centigrade. Correct? So if you see, at 99 degrees centigrade, water is hot. But you can only use it to boil water. That's it. It is really hot. But you can only put some cold water and have a bath. But at 100 degrees centigrade, you can move a train. The difference between the two is 1 degree centigrade. So buddies, now what we need to do is, we need to put that 1 degree more. We need to put that 1 degree more. So 1 degree more if we put, then sky is the limit, absolutely no tension. 1 degree more, we need to push and put that 1 degree more. So in the next 8, 9 days, 10 days, whatever, let's put that 1 degree more. Let's revise all the important areas and let's ensure that we do really well. My uncle was in the army, my mom's cousin. So what happened was he had very high fever when he was in the Indian Military Academy training. He still tells me the story. One day the commanding officer came inside at 2 a.m. and he put a bucket of water and he say, "Cadet, get up now. I want you to run 2 kilometers." He said, "But sir, I have fever. I cannot run. I have 101 degree." "I don't care. Just run." "Sir, no, I cannot run." He said, "Now that you told me that you cannot run, it was 2 kilometers. Now I made it 3 kilometers. Run now." So this guy now started running. He started running. In almost 200 meters, he collapsed. He collapsed. He could not take it. 200 meters, he collapsed. The commanding officer came and said, "Hey, cadet, get up and run." "Sir, sorry, my legs are not allowing me. My legs are shivering." You know what that commanding officer said? My uncle still remembers. He gets goosebumps even today, though he's retired now. And my uncle still, what do you say, sheds a tear because the commanding officer, with such power, he looked into his eyes and he said, "Cadet, run with your mind, not just your legs." So guys, I know most of you are already tired. You'll be like, May exam, then November exam, I can't be at peace, I don't know what to do. But guys, don't worry. You have to run with your mind now, not with your legs. Now is the time to run with your mind. Just run. I know you are completely down and out, but you need to run. We have a few days for the exam. Don't count the days for the exam and all those things. Prepare well and do it. I don't have to tell you anything now because you have already prepared. You have taken guidance under so many people. But I again repeat, if your mental health is awesome, if you are strong enough, then you can aram se handle anything. Every subject will become very easy to handle, though every subject has quality. Law has quality, EIS has quality, audit has quality. But you can nail each and every exam, I can assure you that, right? I can assure you that you can nail each and every exam without a doubt. So do not worry, guys. You need to run with your mind and not with your legs. So my uncle told me this story and I want to share that with you. And ultimately, people will underestimate you, people will think that you are not cut out for CA, people, your own parents sometimes because of relatives' pressure, your own parents may doubt you saying that, is my son capable of doing CA, is my daughter capable of, the mild thought will come. But what I am trying to tell is, for example, this guy always wanted to become, he had in his mind already had made up his mind, right, that I will become one day the CEO of Toyota. People laughed at him, you will become CEO of Toyota, are you kidding me? You cannot become anybody, you will not be anybody, you will not become CEO of Toyota and all that, you are a nobody. He finished his engineering, worked really hard, and after an engineer, becoming an engineer, he went to the Toyota company for a job. They threw him out, first only they threw him out, they said get out. Then again he went, they threw him out, again he went, they threw him out. Fourth time the watchman actually held his collar and threw him out of the thing. So the thing is, he went back to his shed, garage, he was crying. Neighbors came and said, hey, what happened, man? His name was actually Soikiro. He said, hey Soikiro, what happened, why are you crying? Soikiro said, no, I had my dream of becoming the CEO, CEO of Toyota company, but then they are not allowing me to become a low level engineer also. They said, it's okay, why don't you do it on your own? So they all scrambled for some money and gave him some money and said, why don't you start something? So this guy started in his garage and his full name is Soikiro Honda. People underestimated Soikiro Honda. And Soikiro Honda started the Honda company, which became one of the largest companies in the world. And Honda has gone to Toyota almost 3 times to take over Honda. Take over Toyota. He has gone there to take over Toyota. Think about it. A person who wanted to become the CEO of Toyota, people underestimated him, and today he is the owner of the Honda company. So do not underestimate yourself. Do not let anybody else underestimate you. You are, each of you is a winner, buddies. All you need to do is have that in your mind and just go ahead. It is relevant for both inter and final. You just need to move ahead, buddies. That's all I'm trying to tell. And lastly, Brian Acton, if you see, on 23rd May 2009, think about the positive attitude. He said, got denied by Twitter headquarters. That's okay, it would have been a long commute. He's telling, it's okay, it would have been a long commute, it's fine, no problem. And again, Brian Acton into 3rd August 2009, Facebook turned me down. He wanted to get a job in Facebook. Facebook turned me down. It was a great opportunity to connect with some fantastic people. Looking forward to life's next adventure. Think about the positive attitude. But he was sad. He had a very small office, guys, with around 20 computers, very, very small office. So Twitter also turned him down. Facebook also turned him down, and he had a very small office. So he came back and he sat down in his office. Little sad he was because two of the biggest companies turned him down. His friend came and patted his back and said, hey man, what's up? Suddenly he turned and he said, what did you say? I said, what's up? Idea. He created WhatsApp. The same Facebook which had rejected him bought WhatsApp after a few years for $19.6 billion. Can you believe it or not? $19.6 billion. Never underestimate your worth. I know you are in a low path now. I know you are going through hell. But never underestimate yourself. I may be taking a class out of the 200 people here. I may be taking a class now to the next Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu, the next Prime Minister of India, next Chief Minister of Karnataka, Chief Minister of Telangana, Finance Minister of Andhra Pradesh, you never know. Do not underestimate your worth, buddies. Think about it. You are really powerful. Do not underestimate it. CA Inter, you will clear, and that is my promise. You will do it. And lastly, but not the least, this guy is not Virat Kohli. This guy is not Rahul Dravid. This guy is a nobody, but his name is Hokkaido Zimomi, and as you can see, he is a Ranji player, and he was picked up by the Kolkata Knight Riders. He never got a match, but they paid him 20 lakhs. He was always the ball boy. He was carrying all the, every time somebody wanted to drink something, he went and used to, you know, give this drinks to them. So at the end of the day, he was just a cricket player who nobody knew, but he is the only cricket player from Nagaland, a very small village in Nagaland, to come. He used to trek almost 5 kilometers a day to play cricket in his village. After he became a cricket player, electricity came, then what do you say, water came. Coming to think of water, I need to take a sip quickly. Thank you guys for reminding me. You guys are only reminding me actually. Sorry. So electricity came, water came, right? And then what happened? He became a cricket player. Today in his village, they worship Hokkaido Zimomi. They don't care who is Virat Kohli. They don't know who is Sachin Tendulkar. They don't know who is Rahul Dravid. But Hokkaido Zimomi is number one in their hearts. They worship him. So guys, one very, very bad thing that I have actually seen among CA inter students, they compare with their friends. They compare with their friends. Buddies, I am telling you, your friend may be Virat Kohli, your other friend may be Rahul Dravid, your other friend may be Sachin Tendulkar. They may be really good, but always remember, they are also a cricket player, you are also a cricket player. They are also a CA student, you are also a CA student. Out of 800, they may get 500, they may get 600, no problem. But you are a person who is like Hokkaido Zimomi. You will score 400 out of 800. But at the end of the day, they are also a chartered accountant. You are also a chartered accountant. Correct? Always remember, do not compare with friends. One dirty habit I have seen, after the exam, immediately you will come out and say, bro, what is the answer for this, bro? Macha, what is the answer for this? Why? Can you go change the answer? Why do you discuss? Please do not discuss. These are some tips, because one thing I'll tell you, first exam accounts, if you discuss, and then you know that you've gone, your all answers are wrong. Then you go to the next exam, mindset again, gone. Mindset gone. So always, please do not compare with your friends. Don't talk to your friends only. Don't talk to your friends. If they are coming and telling, what is the answer for this? You start singing one song. You start singing one song. That's all. Don't listen to them. If they tell, what is the answer for that? You will tell, tomorrow you come, I'll tell you. Correct? That's all. You don't listen to them. You don't talk to them only. Correct? Then if they come and ask, what is the answer for this? Who are you? I don't know. Who are you? Who are you? Why are you coming and asking? Hey, it's me, your friend. Now you come. You ask this, then I'll talk to you. Do not, you know, please discuss with your friends. Be Hokkaido Zimomi. No need to compare yourself with Virat Kohli and all that. It's absolutely fine, guys. Okay? So do not be like this. So this is what I want to tell you guys. As far as the Companies Act is concerned, there are so many changes, guys. It was earlier 1956, correct? Then it became 2013. Then it 2015 Amendment Act came. 2017 Amendment Act came. 2019 Amendment Act came. Keeps on coming, keeps on changing. It is never ending. So we need to keep ourselves updated, correct? So we need to understand all these things and keep ourselves updated. So that is the idea that I want to tell you, that so many things are there and we need to ensure that we do it. All this you leave, these are all the basic stuff. Syllabus has been altered and we are already like this, huh? Syllabus altered, so that's the thing. So passage of Companies Act and all for regular batch, it's fine. But there are many new concepts you may have known. One person company, independent director, KMP, woman director, small company, resident director, dormant company, National Company Law Tribunal, Internal Financial Control, auditors, rotation and all those things, okay? So these are the things. So Companies Act, we have 470 sections, out of which you have around 128 sections for your examination. Yes, so to prevent the entire crash in the entire crash course, you need to remember, you need to concentrate well. So my assumptions that you've already studied, you're expected to know the subject, we're expected to answer the questions when we were throw some questions. It is not for the ones who obviously not touched the book. You should have studied first. And of course, guys, you need to understand, it's just a crash course. Full subject cannot be covered. I already told you, it's just a revision batch. Quickly, I'll revise everything. And wherever, whatever is important, we'll discuss. So you, if you expect me to do everything, because I take almost 100 hours, correct? 100 hours or something I will take in the entire syllabus, not regular class, 100-120 hours. You can't expect me to do 120 hours in just 20 hours, right? 15-20 hours, it's not possible. So it's just a crash batch, but you will obviously understand everything. So for the old syllabus, around 127 sections are there. For the new syllabus, it is, you know, two other chapters are added. That is chapter number 9 and chapter number 10. These two chapters are also added. These two chapters, no, that is accounts and audit, will also come for you in auditing. So generally for me, that is actually auditing. So that's why I told around 120 odd sections for you. But nevertheless, that part is good for you because it comes for law also, it comes in auditing also, okay? That is what they are trying to tell. So some important concept before we begin. One is you need to jot down everything and all those things. I will tell you how to do that. Understand the concept, interact with me. You have this chat option, kindly interact, ask doubts, and you need to make a pledge today that you will score, you know, at least 60 plus in law. You will try for an exemption. Rather than an exemption, I would say 60 plus. Because exemption, if you see the definition, exemption is where you have flunked in other subjects but scored 60 plus. I don't want you to get exemption. I want you to get 60 plus, which means you should already do that also. Correct? Yes. So if you see, that's the thing, guys. So if you have not touched law, just try to attend the classes, something you will understand. The time which is less, Shivanandu, it is difficult for you to cover everything, but just follow the class. That's what I want to say. So guys, I want you to write down today's date, 14th September. Write down in your paper and all that now. 14th September, let us write 2024. I will tell you why I am writing this. 14th September 2024. Write down 14 September 2024. Sir, but it is not 14 September 24 today. It is 20. No problem. Write down. Right? Write down. So when you say jot down, I mean write down. You write down the name. Your name you write down, not my name. Right? You should write down the name. Just before your name. Just before your name. Write these two wonderful letters. Write down two wonderful letters before your name. CA dot your name. How does it feel, guys? You please see for 10 seconds your name. CA dot your name. CA dot your name. How does it feel? So in 4 years from today, when you open this book or whatever, if you have it, what you see should be what you already are. You should be a chartered accountant. How does it feel? Isn't it an amazing feeling? You will join the very, very small group of niche professionals and you will be a chartered accountant. We have around 120 crores population. In that, just 3 lakh are chartered accountants, of which, of course, around 1 lakh have already died. So basically, guys, you just have 2 lakh chartered accountants, living chartered accountants in India, and you guys will be a part of that amazing team. You need to think already that you are a CA. That doesn't mean from tomorrow you start signing audit report certificate. I don't do all that, guys. But what I am trying to tell is, you need to believe that you are a chartered accountant. You need to believe that you are a CA. You should ignore the people who put you down. You should ignore the people who think that you can't do it, even if that person happens to be you. Correct? So you need to write down stuff and you need to crystal clear understand that you will be a chartered accountant. On that note, let us begin. And one thing you need to understand, Regulation 39 of CA Regulation says, Regulation 39 of CA Regulation says that if you are doing CS and all, you can write CS, no problem. CA Regulation clearly says, what does it say? It says that they can revise the marks if need be. So they can make it plus 5 up to or up to minus 5. So always remember, always remember that if it is 40 or 50, it is not 40 or 50, you should ideally score 45 and 55. You should ideally score 45 and 55, correct? So you should always remember, buddies, that you should score 45 to 55, right? That range you have to do. It should not be 40 and 50, because even if they reduce the marks tomorrow, here and there if they reduce, it's absolutely okay. If they reduce the mark here and there also, you will be in a very, very good position. You will be in an excellent, excellent position. You will be in an excellent position because even if they reduce, even if they do whatever it is, you will get it. All right. So I'll be doing, yeah, thank you, Shashank. So the agenda I will tell you, guys, if you see. lungs are still little weak, it'll be fine. Cool, the agenda is very simple, guys. I will be quickly revising company law and allied law. Okay, for company law, see, these are the chapters that we have. We have the prelims, which is, you know, incorporation, prospector, share capital, all these are there. 30% to 40% come in these areas. And again, acceptance of deposits, registration, management and administration, 30% to 40% come from these areas. So totally it's for 60 marks. So here you can say around 40% means anywhere between 18 to 24 marks come. And here in acceptance of deposit, again between 18 to 24 marks come. And here 25% to 35% around 15 to 20 marks comes here. And again 15 to 20 marks or 25 marks comes in auditing. So these three chapters are also there in audit. These three chapters are also there in auditing. That is why it is very, very important. Correct? It will be very, very important. As far as other laws are concerned, I will quickly brush through. So I have made charts. I have made charts. So let me just, I'll come to that. I'll tell you what I'm going to do immediately. Okay. This is what it is. So here, if you see the remaining 40 marks, all these things come. So Contract Act takes the cake, by the way. Contract Act takes the cake. So this will be, of course, you know, you will be pushing it through and you'll be doing it really well there, because this comes for almost around 15 marks. Around negotiable instruments comes from 6 to 8 marks. General clauses and interpretation of statutes comes. So let's quickly try to revise that. Let's see what can be done. Okay. Now, finally, all this you leave. Finally, like this guy, Shri Shri Swami Nityananda, always smiling. So we can learn something from everybody. This guy, rape accused now, he has a country called Kailasa. Think about it. He has his own Reserve Bank of Kailasa. He has a currency. So guys, anything can happen to anybody. So you need to be smiling always. Always keep smiling. Do not worry. Correct? On that note, one quick funny thing in 2 minutes, and we'll dive into our class. IPCC, remember, IPCC CA Inter, in CPT we carried 4 books. In IPCC, this many books you have to carry. Crazy it is. So many books you have to carry. Correct? When I went to the institute, we had to carry that time. So when we had to go to the institute, first CPT they gave me books, I carried in my two-wheeler. IPCC I went in a two-wheeler only, they gave me so many bundles. I had to take an auto. Then he told, in CA final, bring a mini lorry. That's what happened. Correct? So if you see, that's what happened. Next, in accounting, in class, they ask question like this. In class, they solve questions like this, very easy. In exam, what comes? This comes. Correct? Exam, this comes. That is what is going to happen. Correct? That's what? Full ulta. You will study something, what comes only is a different thing. Then, this is the best part. That is why I am telling, do not compare. Correct? While everyone is arguing whether the profit is 2 lakh 50 or 2 lakh 60, after exam you'll come full josh, all full josh they'll come. And bro, what is the answer? 2 lakh 50? No, bro, what is the answer? 2 lakh 65. You will be like, okay, they are arguing 2 lakh. So you'll talk to 20 people as usual. 10 people will tell 2 lakh 50. 10 people will tell 2 lakh 65. You are the only person with loss 5 lakh 35. It has happened to you, yes or no? 5 lakh 35 loss. You'll be like, what happened? You are telling 2 lakh 60. You are telling 2 lakh 50. For me, loss has come. No, 5 lakh 35 thousand. So if you see, that is the worst thing that can happen. So correct. Please do not compare with your friends. Start singing. Correct. So you start singing when your friend asks what is the answer and all those things. Yes. Yeah. Amendments will be covered. All the relevant amendments. During registration, CA Institute will be like this. Please come like that. Correct. But in during exams, it becomes Brock Lesnar. Same position and all, same only. Just that the aggression will be different. Correct. During registration is one thing. During exams, it's a totally different thing. Then, costing. If you say costing, where are the working notes in the problem? You will tell in costing. Thank you. So, where are the working notes in the problem? The evaluator is asking. The evaluator is asking, where are the working notes in the problem? So you forgot to write working notes. What will you say? Bro, it is in the calculator. So you see on your own. In the evaluator is telling, hey, I am writing this. I want to see where is the working notes. You are telling it's already in the calculator. So that's the thing. Anyway, if anybody gets exemption in costing and all, no, you'll be like, oh, full. And exemption in EISSM. Think about it. So if you see, that is the thing. So if you see there, four kinds of people in ITSM. One fellow like this, one fellow like this, one fellow already gone. I was always like this, guys. In EIS SM class, always sleeping. There are only four types of people, nobody else. IPC student reaction, when accounts one come, onion, hey, like that, full Josh. While ITSM comes, that is EIS, by the time EIS SM comes, no, they would have completely, you know, drilled, sucked every 1 ounce of energy. It's a wonderful experience writing, you know, CI inter examination. So that is how it really works. ITSM or EIS SM, when you're writing first 3 hours, may 160 minutes, you don't know much of what to write dire. Last 20 minutes, chumma hit properly. That's the thing. So last 20 minutes, write whatever you feel like. That's the thing. That is the EIS SM. Who is a CA student who updates? That is relatable for us now. Writing my IPCC exams this May, writing my CA inter exams this May, you will say. Then you will again share the Facebook memory in 2 years, because next May also I'll be writing that. Correct? So that is the most important thing that you have to see. This is the best part. In law exam, everybody is using calculator. You're like, hey, calculator in law exam. You see here, everybody is using. You are seeing where is the problem here. Where is the problem? One problem also I didn't find. No, everybody is using calculator. After you go outside, you'll say, macha, why were you using calculator? You show me where is the problem. No, I was calculating whether I'll be getting 42 or 39 in law. No, I'll get 4. I was calculating that. Each question I was calculating. Correct? So if you see, that is what I'm trying to tell in law. So, but heated gold is called ornament. Beaten copper is called wire. Compressed carbon is called diamond. But heated, beaten and compressed person is called chartered accountant. Correct? That's all it is. So you should never give up, buddies. You should be like this, frog. If CA Institute is like that swan, you are like that frog, always trying to do something. 5 years, 50 laws, 500 lectures, 5,000 case laws, 50,000 sections, 5 lakh rules. Normal human being cannot do it. The rest of us are called chartered accountants. I am a chartered accountant. You will become a chartered accountant very, very soon. Let us work so hard that one day our signature will be called as what? Audited financial statement under section 143. Normal paper, no. But if I write this, it will be called as audited financial statement. So guys, generally I give chocolate in my first class, but since we are in the virtual thing, the chocolate is coming to you. Think of it that you are having a chocolate. Okay. On that note, let us begin, buddies. So the first class, the first 1 hour, I always want to just motivate you. Are you feeling motivated? Yes or no? Are you motivated enough to start now? Yes, no. Yes, brilliant. So I'm going to tell you what all we are going to be doing and all those things, right? Yes, so this is what we need to do. Great. Cool. So guys, very, very simple. So first of all, now 6 to 7, I wanted to do that motivation. Now it is done. From now, every day classes will be from 6 to 8. Today I'll do it till 8 o'clock. Every day class will be from 6 p.m. to 8 p.m. So we will be doing a quick revision of all the concepts. I will also try to do allied law also, because that is important. 40 marks come, people do it. Generally leave that. So we'll try to cover amendments, we'll try to do everything, no problem. We'll try to do some basics today properly, because there are some things which are very, very important which we are going to cover today. So material I will be sending. And for allied law, especially Indian Contract Act, there are charts that also I'll be sharing with you. Okay, it's very important. I'll show you the charts. So what I have done now, one day before the exam, simply revise the charts. So there are some basics of Indian Contract Act that we should know, quick basics. So these are the charts. This also will be, I'll be checking it properly, right? And I'll be seeing all your questions, whatever you are asking. These charts also I'll be sharing with you. Okay, it's going to be shared on the group. Now, I have a group for CA final. Basically, even inter students are there. It is called CAPJ Virtual. My name is Punarvas Jaikumar, that is why PJ. Right? So, correct? CAPJ Virtual. So, if you see, you can, this is my Telegram group. So, you can join the group today, right? And my channel, you already have subscribed, please subscribe to the channel. Because now whatever classes are going to happen in this particular channel. CAPJ Virtual, CAPJ Virtual, it is on Telegram. In that there is a small discussion button also, click on the discussion button, you will take the discussion group. In this I will be uploading the material, whatever material I will give you, I will be giving the charts also. And during the course of our discussion, I will be making charts for company law also. So you can quickly jot down or you can take a picture, okay? Since you guys have been sent this particular link, so you can watch these videos and all that. Probably later I will be putting it up on my YouTube channel also. As of now it is an unlisted video because I didn't want any distractions and other nonsense. That's why I just want these many students who can do it, okay? That's my agenda, as simple as that, okay? So did you understand? Material and the charts will be sent on the Telegram group, on my Telegram group CAPJ Virtual, okay? So which has some amendments and some notes, whatever it is, give me one day, I will make some, I already have all the notes, I need to make it little appealing to you, because you should know which structure to follow. I'll be sharing that with you, no tension. Telegram channel, join, I will send you these charts also, no tension, don't worry, okay? Then I'll also be sending, let me see, whatever material I have which is good for you, which is good for the examination, I'll be sharing, okay? As I told you when we did this revision also, we are not in a, the business of doing two classes, then asking you, give me 50 rupees, give me 100 rupees and all that. These classes will be 100% free, okay? And because my true intention is to help the students, and I did not want to cancel. I felt very bad because I had promised 11th September and now I am doing it on 14th. I felt very bad, but health, nothing can be done. Doctor told till 13th September you cannot take any class. Actually till 12th September, 13th in the morning, do not take any class. I have been allowed to take only 2 hours a day. I am utilizing everything for you guys, okay? I cannot take more than that, at least for the next 15 days once I get back. After that, I am gonna kill it. So next 10-15 days it's going to happen like that, okay? So very simple, we'll plan it out in such a way that we are going to do this coolly. All the amendments will cover, all the important areas will cover, correct? Do not expect me to do everything, guys. You please put that in your mind, be reasonable. I cannot do everything, it's going to be revision. You should have already studied once, okay? And charts also I'll give you, don't worry. This is how it's going to happen. So today we will be doing some very very important basics, which is gonna go for the next which is very very important basics, which are going to help us in the future, okay? So now first question, sorry, one second. Question number one, thank you guys, you guys are only reminding, very sweet of you, thank you so much. I keep forgetting, that is what used to happen. 14 hours I used to take class, never used to drink water, never used to take meals on time. That's why I learned my lesson. Corona said, "Macha, this fellow's lungs is open. Let's attack." That's why it attacked. So I know in my passion towards teaching, I sort of tend to miss out on all these things, but not anymore. You guys are only so sweetly reminding me. Thank you so much. I feel very nice. Thank you. Right? I will tell you. First of all, how to study law? How to present the answer? Should I write section number and all that Karthik has asked? I have already made a video of around 45 to 50 minutes. It is on my YouTube channel, Punarvas Jaikumar Law Classes. It is there only, how to present answers. It is relevant for CA final also. It is relevant for IPCC also. My student has scored around 70 plus. I will share that paper also with you on Telegram. So you will get an idea what all you should do to get 70. She scored some 72 if I am not wrong. Okay. That's the thing. So this video you please go through. Maybe tomorrow morning or today, whatever, whenever it is. So Karthik, your doubt will be cleared with that. How to study law, how to present, and what is, whether to write section number, not to write section number, and all those things. Correct? This is the thing. You can watch later. This video is already there. It's a 45 to 50 minute video already there. So please watch that tomorrow or whenever you feel like watching, watch. There I have told you a section number mandatory. For CA final, it is mandatory. For CA inter, it's okay, guys. It's absolutely okay. Even if you cannot write it, it's okay. But for CA final, it is mandatory. So in that video, you will say, you will see that I'll be telling, yeah, yeah, it is mandatory. But for CA inter, it's okay. If you can write, good. If you don't want to write, no problem. But all the other aspects are equally relevant for CA final and CA inter. So please do watch this video. This is a 45 to 50 minute video. This anyway I would have done today. But the thing is, I wanted to do the motivation because people were asking me so many questions. And they said, sir, we need to first attune our mind to this and then we will do this. Can you please do that? That is what we are trying to tell. Okay? That's the first part. Now, let us move into some basics. Basics. First and foremost, we all know that company is a separate legal entity. Correct? And there are two things there. It is controlled by the board of directors also, and it is controlled by the shareholders also. Correct? It is controlled by the board of directors and shareholders. If I ask you a question, who is more powerful? Is it the board of directors or is it shareholders? You may not have an answer. You may not have an answer. Correct? But the beauty of Companies Act, the beauty of law, is given in section 179. Section 179. If I show you the section, sir, this is not in my syllabus. No, this is very much part of your syllabus. The entire section, section 1 to section 148, is governed by the mother section, section 179. If I ask you the question, some of you may say shareholders, some of you may say board, but it is different. Correct? So we need to understand clearly the section 179. So section 179 is the mother section of law, which speaks about board. So generally I teach from the BARE Act. That's why people have given me the, I mean, I don't know if I deserve it or not, but they have given me the tag of BARE Act decoder. Because that is my specialty. I decode, we try to decode each and every line word of the BARE Act. Nothing is more pure than studying from the law as passed in the parliament. So we have to study from the BARE Act. Sir, I have few months to go for the exam. How will I study from BARE Act? You don't worry about all that. For whatever I do in this class, you follow, it's more than enough. Okay? Now, if you see, the board of directors of the company shall be entitled to exercise all such powers and to do all such acts and things as the company is authorized to exercise and do, is what they are trying to tell. Do not worry. I will break this down now very clearly. What they are trying to tell is simple words. You follow the simple words now. In simple words, section 179 is telling the board of directors can do whatever the company could have done if company had brains of its own. If the company had its own brains, whatever the company could have done, who can do now? Board of directors can do. But there is one more exception to this rule. Exception, which is given here. You leave that. I will only tell you. Here it says, board of directors cannot do those things. Board of directors cannot do those things which the shareholders can do. First dialogue, what did I say? Board of directors can do whatever they want to do. Correct? If the company have those powers, company has those powers, whatever the company could have done, who can do? Board of directors can do. But then the second line, board of directors cannot do those things which the shareholders can do. And buddies, what can the shareholders do? It is only given in the Act, then the AOA and the MOA. So, shareholders' powers are limited to what? Shareholders' powers are limited to Act, AOA and MOA. AOA is what? Articles of Association. MOA is Memorandum of Association. Together they are called as the Charter of the company or the Constitution of the company. The Memorandum of Association speaks about what? One second, let's change the battery. Yes, thank you. Add. So, come again. The shareholders, right? Their powers are only given in the Act, in the MOA and the AOA. The AOA and MOA are called as the Charter of the company, and Act we all know, Companies Act. So, still here it's not clear. Here they are telling, board can do whatever the company could have done, okay. But shareholders can do only those things which the Act prescribes, AOA prescribes or MOA prescribes. Now the interesting thing is some examples we need to take. If you see here only, 179 subsection 3, board of directors can do the following things only at the meetings of the board. For example, borrowing money, investing funds, granting loans. See, the Act is only very clear. It is giving the power to whom? Only to the board of directors. In this, what I am trying to tell is, I will just give you an example. For instance, in section 179.3, the Act is giving the power only to the board of directors to borrow money, to invest funds and all those things, okay. But if you see very interestingly, in section 169, do not worry about the section numbers that I am using. Oh, this fellow is using section numbers and all that. Do not worry. Absolutely do not worry, buddies, okay. I am just using, because I mean I have studied the law in depth, I know it, but this is just to give you examples. Do not worry about it. See the concept behind. Don't worry about the section numbers, okay. Do not bother about section numbers. Just see the concept. In section 169, the Act has given power to the shareholders only. This is about removal of director. Removal of director. Correct? Removal of director. So, Act has given the power to the board of directors under section 179.3 only to the board. Do you think shareholders can interfere here? No. Can shareholders interfere? No way. Similarly, under section 169, removal of director, Act has given power to the shareholder. Can the board of directors interfere? No way. There are a few sections, there are a few sections where Act tells, bro, board of director, you have to come with the shareholders, come together and do it. So come together and then do the transactions. For example, section 180. Don't go by the section number, don't be scared. Don't be scared. Ignore the section number. Ignore the section number. Ignore the section number, guys. Don't be scared at all. Okay. So section 180 says this is about selling an undertaking. If I want to sell a branch, if I want to sell a part of my company, don't you think so? I should ask my shareholders. Yes. So the Act is very, very clear. Act gives power to both board as well as the shareholders. 179.3, Act gives the power to the board. Section 169, Act gives the power to the shareholders. Correct? 179.3, Act gives the power to the board. 169, Act gives the power to the shareholders. Removal of director and all those things. Then, Act sometimes gives the power to the board and the shareholders. This is all okay. Is all okay. One section I will show you which is in your syllabus. I will show you one section which is in your syllabus. That is called Notice of Meeting 101. Do not be scared. I am showing the Bayer Act. oh, 2 months to go for the exam, I have never touched Bear Act in my life, do not worry at all. I am coolly seeing the Bear Act just to make you understand. If you have never touched the Bear Act, absolutely no problem. When you come to me in CA final, I will train you, don't worry, okay? Now, notice of the meeting. If you see this line, a notice, general meeting of a company may be called by giving not less than 21 days notice either in writing or through electronic mode or in such manner as may be prescribed. A general meeting of the company may be called by giving not less than clear 21 days notice. Where do we get Bear Act for knowledge purposes? I will tell you. You can download an app on Play Store. You just search for Companies Act on the Play Store. Then you will see a company called MMJC Advisory. It is a free app. I am not associated with this company and all. It is a free app which even I use. It is absolutely free. It is 100% updated. So if you want just to refer, you can download this app. Sir, I have kidney phone, sir. I don't go by this Chapadasi Android. I am kidney phone. Then I don't know. Okay. So you please go to this particular thing. Okay. You can download that app. Kidney phone and all if you have, I don't know what, which app and all to use. Okay. Coming back. What in 179.3, what did I say? Act has given the power to the board. Okay, shareholders will not interfere because Act is supreme. In 169, what did I say? Act has given the power to shareholders. So, will the board of directors interfere? No way. Now, Act sometimes has given the power to what? Both board of directors and shareholders. Act has given power to both board of directors and shareholders under section 160. Now, my question is, what if the Act is silent? Act doesn't give power to anybody. Act doesn't give power to anybody. What do I do? Act doesn't give power to anybody. What do I do? So if I see here, 101, check it out. A general meeting of the company may be called by giving not less than 21 clear days notice either in writing or through electronic mode. Macha, who can give notice, Macha? Don't know. Company can give or shareholders can give. You will get doubt in CA inter exam now. MCQ they will give. A general meeting notice shall be given by dash. Board of directors, shareholders, none of these, one of these. Huh? What to do? Now the beauty of 179 will come into force. In 179, what did you see? In 179, what did you see? Whatever the board can do, whatever the company could have done if company had brains of its own. The board of directors can do whatever the company could have done if company had brains of its own. When the Act is silent, the law, section 179, is indirectly telling the board of directors to take care of everything. This is a CA inter question. There's a case law also on this. LIC versus Escorts. LIC versus Escorts was based on this only. They didn't know who will give the explanatory statement. Who will give? Board of directors. So it's very clear. Act gives the power to board. Board. Act gives the power to shareholder. Shareholder. Act doesn't give any power. Board of directors. Did you get it? Basics. I'm building the foundation. Basics. You may not have studied like this before. It's okay. I'm building the basics for you. Okay? Are you guys understanding? Are you guys with me? All of you with me, buddies? Yes or no? Yes. All right. Now, next. One more question. The act is powerful or AOA or MOA? Act is powerful or AOA or MOA? Who is more powerful? Who is more powerful? Who is more powerful? Act is powerful or AOA MOA? Act. That is again there in your syllabus, section number 6. Section number 6 says the Act overrides the AOA and MOA. Act is supreme. Right? Act is supreme. Act overrides the AOA and MOA. Always. Act overrides the AOA and MOA always. But that starts off with a line. Section 6 starts off with a line which says unless otherwise specified. Which means there are certain sections where the Act gives power to the AOA slash MOA. The Act gives power to AOA or MOA to actually override the Act or to specify something which is more than the Act. For example, again from your syllabus I am extracting. There is section 55 which is about issue of preference shares. There is section 63 2A. Sir, section number and all you are telling. Don't worry at all. I am just writing. Think of me like I am showing off. This fellow is showing off. Assume. Okay. So, do not worry about section number. 63 2A. Issue of bonus shares. So, I'll show you that section to make you understand. Okay. Don't worry about section number. Don't get scared. There is no booth here, no problem. It is just an act. It is pretty easy. Let us respect that act. It will give us benefit, a lot of benefit. Okay. You see 63 subsection 2. See here you see. It is authorized by the articles. No company shall capitalize its profits or reserves for the purpose of issuing fully paid up bonus shares unless it is authorized by the articles. Means what? Here they are telling, if the articles are silent, section does not apply. If you want to give bonus shares, it should be authorized by the articles. Got it? If Act is silent, if articles is silent, section does not apply. If articles are silent, section does not apply. Got it? So, if you see buddies here, if articles are silent, section does not apply. Don't you think so? It's an exception. Till now you were telling act is powerful. Now I am telling that section only will not apply if the articles are silent. But who made it like that? Again the Act. So Act gives power to the AOA and MOA to override the Act. What are the examples? Section 55, issue of preference shares. What are the other examples? 63 2A, issue of bonus shares. One more example, 68 2A, buyback of shares, BB, buyback. Correct? Buyback of shares. Are you getting my point? These are some of the examples. Where if the Act is silent, section does not apply. This is the exception to the general rule where Act is more powerful that you say. Now all these things that I told you still does not answer my question. Who is more powerful? Still does not answer my question. So, I as a shareholder will go to the MCA and say, bro MCA, bro, I am the person who have given the capital to the company. I should be more powerful. Okay? Let's say I am a 100% shareholder of the company. I will walk into the company. Company secretary will stand up. CFO will stand up. Sir, please come, sir. Please come sit, sir. How are you, sir? Are you fine? Sir, I'll give you masala dosa, coffee, all that. Please eat, sir. I ate. I'm a 100% shareholder. I'm not a director, but I'm a 100% shareholder. I will now ask the company secretary, sir, I just want to see the accounts. Can you please show me, sir? I just want to see how the accounts are going. Can you please show me? Company secretary will look at chartered accountant CFO. CFO will look at company secretary. Company secretary will look at me and say, sir, I'm very sorry, sir. I cannot give you the details. You'll be like, boss, I am the owner, 100% shareholder. I am just asking you, it is September, show me the accounts. I want to see. Company secretary says, sir, with all due respect, you had nicely, you had dosa and all. Please leave, sir. I'm like, arey yaar, what is this? I am the bloody owner here. Each and every asset that you have bought here is because of me. Company secretary says, sir, no, sir. Solomon versus Solomon, you are different, company is different. Lee versus Lee Air Farming, you are different, company is different. Bachcha F. Guzdar versus Commissioner of Income Tax, you are different, company is different. You have not taken any property. It is company's property. Mekora versus Northern Assurance Company Limited. Me, like this. Company secretary selling full case law section number and all that. What am I doing there? Then I will raise my voice. You should give me the accounts. Show me where it is given in the act that I will not be getting the accounts. So company secretary will give you the bare act and say, open 128 subsection 3. Open 128 subsection 3. That is also in your syllabus. That is also in your syllabus. 128 subsection 3. What does it say? It says, the books of accounts and other books and papers maintained by company within India shall be open for inspection only by a director. I am seeing the paper. I am seeing like this. Is there any spelling mistake? You give me, I'll watch it on the soft copy also. I am zooming in and watching. Only director? Shareholder is a chaprasi fellow. Shareholder does not have any right. Company secretary says, sir, no, sir, you don't have any right. You don't have any right. Thank you, Priyanka. You don't have any right. Right? You don't have any right. That's what the shareholder, I mean, the company secretary will tell. I get full pissed off. I go to MCA. That's the story. MCA, bro, cheating. MCA is what? Ministry of Corporate Affairs, main ministry. I'll go to tell and macha, what is this da? You told me you invest in the company. You invest in the company, correct? You will give me full power. Like in chaprasi, I go there. They gave me all. They treated me nicely. When I asked for the accounts, they said no. MCA says, cool down, cool. Sit down. Have some water. You want dosa? I just had. I want the answer. Plain dosa. Butter masala, okay, give me. I am eating. No, I want to eat. Get on coffee also. Okay, okay, cool, 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 cool. Sit down, aram se. I will tell you. So that comes, I eat properly. Now tell me, MCA bro, why did you cheat me? You told me I am the owner, I am powerful and all. Okay, cool it, cool it, cool it. Very simple. MCA tells, bro, shareholder bro, you are at the center. Who has the power to check the accounts? Yeah, I saw director. Okay, director. No problem. Shareholder bro, who has the power to appoint a director? No, shareholder is thinking. Who, correct, no? MCA says, bro, go to section 152.2, read with 160. Don't worry about section number. I'm just showing off. I'm just showing off. I'm a big show off. Don't worry. Leave it. Ignore section number. In this, appointment of director is only and only by company, guys. Nobody else. I'll show you proof. Bro, sir, send me proof. Okay, take it. 152 CR. Every director shall be appointed by company in general meeting only. General meeting means what? Shareholders meeting. Directors may inspect the accounts, I agree. Directors may inspect the accounts, I agree. Director may inspect the accounts, I agree. But who can appoint the director? Shareholder only. Then little cool. I'll drink one sip of water. One more coffee I'll get. Are you cool now? Oh yeah, yeah. Get me one more cup. Then they'll tell, bro, you don't like the director. He's, you think that he's cheating you. Throw him out. No. Who has the power? Only you have the power. Section 169, removal of director. Removal of director, only you have the power. Appointment of director, only you have the power. Who is more powerful, Narendra Modi or you? Narendra Modi. Who appointed Narendra Modi? You. Now tell me, who is more powerful? You are getting my point? Right? Then I will say, MCA bro, but still, I can't check the accounts and all, bro. What is this cheating? MCA, have you taken 5 years tapas? Have you done? I'll say no. I'll say no. Have you done 5 years tapas? No. Have you gone through so much hell for 5 years? Have you taken, you know, relatives coming and asking you, what are you doing? Which college? Have you seen attempt after attempt after attempt? No. Who can inspect the accounts? Not you. You are on chapper fellow. There are people with caliber. Caliber must be there. Those caliber fellows only should do. Who are those caliber fellows? That is your last chapter, chapter 9, chapter 10. Appointment of auditor will be done only and only by shareholders and nobody else. Board can do something later. Some cases later we'll see. 152, 2 red with 160, 169, 139. They have the right. You don't have the right. You have not struggled in life. They are dead. They are dead people like this. They are walking. 5 years they'll walk like that. When they come out, you see full suit. GMCS full suit. Interview full suit. Go to them. They are the people with the caliber. Chartered accountants, not you. Go to them. Are you getting my point? Chartered accountant alone can check the accounts and audit, not you. Okay. Are you cool now? I'll say okay, okay, fine. But sir, MCA bro, what if I don't like that auditor bro? No problem, remove. Who has the power to remove? Only and only the shareholder. MCA is telling you, macha, you have 4 solid heavy duty superhero powers. What more do you want? Ah, then I'll be like, cool. There will be one coffee. I'll take a sip of coffee. Then I'll say, okay, okay, fine. Now I'm fine. Who has the power now? These 4 are called pillars of corporate democracy. MCA is telling, shareholder brother, nobody can touch you. Show me one section in the Companies Act called removal of shareholder. Show me one section. Then full. Sorry brother, not there. I am powerful. Yes, full biceps. Correct? Are you getting the beauty of company law? Are you getting it? From these 4, what comes? Again, everything is in your syllabus. What comes from these 4? See, for example, shareholder, 4 powers. 1, ultimately I have to approve the accounts. 2, I want my dividend, that's why I am investing. 3, from here only, director will be appointed. Then here, auditor will be appointed. These 4 items you have to do every single year. That is why these 4 items are called ordinary business, because you do it regularly. Where will it happen? Annual general meeting, come and do. You know our regular adda. South Indian students will understand. Our regular adda, you know, come to our adda. Come to our adda and do adda. Bengali students, Saurav Ganguly, Dada, correct Dada points. Correct? The adda points or Dada points, it stems from this particular thing. Are you understanding the beauty of law? I am an extremely passionate teacher. Law is my life. There is no love life, law life. Correct? So if you see, that's why I forget drinking everything, because I'll be in my own zone. Correct? Once I sit here in class, for me, law will consume me. That's how I am always. So if you see, guys, that's what I'm trying to tell. These are the four, this is in your syllabus. Correct? So what I'm trying to tell is, now still if you ask the question, ultimately, very simple answer. If you want to see the day-to-day operations in life, day-to-day operations, who is more powerful? Board of directors. Day-to-day operations, who is more powerful? Board of directors. But other things, who is more powerful? Other things, who is more powerful? That will be the shareholders. Means four important pillars. The appointment of auditors, removal of auditors, appointment of directors, removal of directors. Four pillars of corporate democracy. Correct? Four pillars of corporate democracy will be handled only by shareholders. Are you clear? So, what did we discuss today? We are seeing sometimes, Act gives the power to board, board will follow. Act gives the power to shareholders, shareholders will follow. Act gives the power to both, board and shareholders, both should follow. Act is silent, board will do it. Who will send the notice of the meeting? Board will do it. Right? Ultimately, in the end, main power I have. But once I appoint the director, MCA is telling, bro, you have appointed the director, no, sit back, aram se, have your masala dosa, have your coffee, sit back, do not interfere. He is a director, he has that mental ability. And you want to see whether they do, see the accounts are fine or not, appoint that other brilliant person, chartered accountant. Chartered accountant will come and do it. Auditor, especially auditor, you should be qualified to be an auditor. Got it? Yes. So this is the thing. Got it? These are the four pillars of corporate democracy. All your questions that you are asking, right, we'll have to discuss. The next part of the thing is, we need to discuss Vishalakshi, it's there only in the first video, check it out, okay? So, if you see, now, there are different things that very, very important concept, very, very important. First is ordinary business, special business. Ordinary resolution, special resolution. Notice and special notice. So many times I have given in the exam, and every time we goof up. Right? Ordinary business, special business. Ordinary resolution, special resolution. Ordinary notice, special notice. Hariharan, that is the only exception, because you have not paid the share money. So by forfeiture, they can forfeit the shares. That is obvious, no? If you are a shareholder and if you have not paid the money, I will give you a warning. Just like that, can I remove? No way. Only by forfeiture it can be removed. That's it. But there is no section in Companies Act which speaks about removal of shareholder like that. I don't like your face, throw you out. I don't like your belt, I'll throw you out. Nothing like that. right? So ordinary business, special business, ordinary resolution, special resolution, ordinary notice, special notice. So this is what we are going to start tomorrow. So tomorrow, for the first 1 hour, we are going to do very important basics. But we'll be doing my first chapter of the introduction. All this we'll discuss all the types of companies and all those things. You would have never studied like that, I can assure you. Small hidden points which you will miss out in exam. So that we will discuss, and then we will go into the first 3 chapters and see what can be done. And we'll also see the amendments. All the amendments we'll see which are relevant for the November examination. We'll see how it can come for the exam, what can be done, all those things. And then we will, with those amendments, we'll link to the relevant chapter also. That's how we do. And see the amendments, link it to the relevant chapter. Okay? So now if I start, it will go on for half an hour. I don't want to simply stretch it like that. Let's do it aram se. So on that note, we will end the class today. I hope it was of help, right? So buddies, on this note, take care, all the best. See you tomorrow, same time, sharp 6 p.m. I'll be here. 6 to 8 p.m. we will do. As I told you, agenda for tomorrow, first half we'll be discussing all these very important basics. In the next half we will see all those other types of resolutions and other amendments and all those things. On that note, buddies, I will take your leave. I had an awesome first session. I hope even you enjoyed. And from the beginning till the end, all of you are staying. We will rock like this. Be sincere to class. Do not miss any class. All right. All the best. Take care, buddies. See you. See you tomorrow. Thank you for reminding me about my water. I will have. Okay. Take care. Thank you so much. Bye.